Hello, science explorers, it's Justin again. And I can't believe I'm saying this, but we are, in fact, back in the desert. This time, it's a cold desert, the coldest desert on Earth, in Antarctica. Mia, are you sure this is a desert? Right. Deserts are places that receive very little rain or snow. All of the fresh water here is frozen, and the ocean water surrounding us is very cold. So the animals here need to adapt to living around salt water, dryness, and extreme cold. Let's find out how they do it. Antarctica is the continent located at the South Pole. The North and South Poles are the areas at the top and bottom of the globe, and the two places on Earth that are farthest away from the equator. That explains why it's so freezing here. The ground here is covered by an ice sheet nearly 1 mile thick, made up of water that's been frozen for ages. Still, there is some plant life here. Grass and moss manage to grow in the warmer months, but animals can't depend on these plants for food throughout the year. So, where is the food? Underwater. Antarctica is surrounded by salty seas that don't freeze over despite the cold temperatures in the air. Most animals here are carnivores, many of them eating fish, shrimp, and other creatures found in the ocean. Here's some of those animals now. A seal pup and its mother. Seals are mammals that spend a lot of their time in the water. You can tell they're mammals from their fur, but it's really short. I wonder if that's all they have to help them keep warm here. And look at their flippers! Aww, they have to flop around on the ice because they have no legs or feet to help them move. Maybe they move around more easily in the water. There's one swimming now. Mia, can you follow them into the water? Wow, they're putting those fins to work. Look how they move like a torpedo through the water. But still, it's so freezing down here. Mia, how can they possibly stay warm in the freezing water? They're what? Blubber? Oh, that's why seals are so big and squishy. They have blubber to keep them warm. Blubber is a special layer of fat that keeps animals warm. It has other advantages too, like storing energy when food is scarce and helping them stay afloat while swimming. Seals can hold their breath underwater for a long time, around 40 minutes. They'll swim down here to look for fish or bigger prey like penguins. Wow, look at the way they glide through the water, almost like they're flying. Penguins are too big to fly, so their wings help them motor through the ocean to escape becoming prey to seals and other ocean predators. On land, they're a little less graceful. Penguins also have a layer of blubber to keep them warm. While their plump bodies are a little slow on land, they give penguins speed and comfort where they need it the most, swimming in the ocean. Wow, look at all of them. This is a colony. A massive group of penguins. Penguins are known to gather in huge groups like this with over 100,000 other penguins. That's enough for a small city. But what could be a benefit to living in a colony? We know resources are scarce here, so why might animals choose to live in such big groups? Take a moment to pause and predict why penguins live in colonies in your field notes. Then we'll take a closer look at what they're doing here. Look at how closely they're standing together. They're shielding each other from the fierce winds, sharing body heat the way we saw deer in the forest do in the winter. Not to mention, it's hard to pick out a single penguin from this huge crowd if you're a predator. And here, do you see the little penguins with brown feathers? Those are chicks. And some parents are watching them while other parents go out to look for food. It's like a daycare for penguins. Down feathers, the brown feathers covering the chicks, give the young penguins a little extra warmth. But adult penguin feathers are warm too, and waterproof. Oh no, this penguin's sneezing. You think it's caught a cold? Oh, Mia says it's using its salt gland. Penguins and many other birds that spend time in the ocean have a salt gland, an organ in the seabirds' noses that helps them get rid of extra salt in their bodies. Birds drink a lot of ocean water when they catch fish, and we know that salt water is not very safe for most animals to drink. Salt glands collect the extra salt, and seabirds basically sneeze the salt out. It's not pretty, but it keeps them healthy. Here's another bird with a salt gland, the albatross. These are the biggest birds on Earth by their wingspan. That's the length of their wings from tip to tip. And albatrosses have a wingspan of around 11 feet. That's as long as a car. Unlike penguins, albatrosses are experts in flight. They can spend weeks at a time in the air and even sleep while they're flying. These long journeys are in search of food for its chicks. Once they find fish, they swallow it and store it in their stomachs for later. Here's another not so pretty adaptation. They regurgitate the food, or bring it back up from their stomach, to feed to their chicks. The penguins do this too, and while this might not be very appetizing to us, it's the easiest way for them to transport lots of food for their families. We've seen so many ways that animals adapt to some of the most extreme environments, but now that we're in one of the colder biomes, I'd like to spend more time learning about the plants and animals that thrive in the cold. We observed a lot of living things in the cold desert today, but I think we'll find even more in another cold biome, the tundra. Thanks for coming along with us on our adventure through the deserts. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers!